Well, if there was ever any doubt about the anger over Victoria's Premier giving himself greater emergency powers, just look at the pictures from Melbourne yesterday. No one's sure what the exact crowd number was, but it's been put in the tens of thousands. Melbourne's biggest demonstration since the pandemic began, in fact. Throughout the crowd, there were placards opposing a controversial bill being debated in the Victorian Parliament. It would transfer powers from the Chief Health Officer to the Premier, giving him the authority to declare a pandemic emergency for up to 3 months. Now, currently, a state of emergency needs to be declared every 4 weeks. Premier Daniel Andrews is currently one vote short of getting the bill through Parliament, with debate to continue this week, along with those protests. Well, for more on this developing story, we're joined now by Victoria's opposition leader, Matthew Guy, and the leader of Victoria's Justice Party, Darren Hinch. Welcome to you both. Darren, we'll start with you. Your party holds the balance of power in the upper house. You could deliver this law to the Premier. What do you plan to do?
We won't. We won't. Right. We've said, made it quite clear, we're voting against it. Look, they keep saying things like, oh, it'll have some sort of a committee to oversee it. But you've got a government majority on that committee, so, you know, that's wasted. And you've got 60 QCs, you've got even their own ombudsman are saying things are wrong with this bill. They've got to go back to the drawing board. It gives far too much power to the government, to the Premier. And you can see, I mean, we had that huge demonstration in Melbourne yesterday, probably the biggest, tens of thousands of people, I don't know the number, and yet we celebrated the first real freedoms that we've had for nearly 2 years. So there's a lot going on, but the Premier's mob wouldn't even speak to my crossbenchers back months ago when they thought they had the numbers. And now we're getting calls at 11 o'clock at night saying, you know, what do you need? What can we do? Well, we're not here to be bought. We won't happen.
Yeah, OK. I want to circle back on the protest, but first, Matthew Guy, these proposed laws have divided the community, as we saw yesterday, but worse, they've led to death threats. What has been going on in Victoria in the last week or so has been absolutely horrifying, and I understand your family's been targeted as well.
Well, a lot of politicians' families have, sadly, and it's obviously very concerning. I mean, I've got little kids, so, you know, when they feature as part of those threats, then it unnerves you. There's no doubt about that. But, you know, what Darren said before about the pandemic bill's right, I think all of us who aren't of the government or their three chosen independents in the upper house, all we want to do is actually have a conversation that's sensible, reasonable. And, you know, if we need to have laws that are changed, well, we'll work with everyone. But when the government tries and rams everything through, you know, it just creates a sense of frustration and anger, and it adds to it. That's part of the problem.
Darren, how do you all, as lawmakers, collectively take the heat out of this issue?
Well, first of all, I was opposed to, I didn't care which side you're on, what the protest's about. People turning up with nooses and gallows is not on in this country. I wish the Prime Minister had actually come out earlier and tougher than he finally did. That's not what Australia is about, and I'm ashamed of it. I got into trouble because I said to people, these are shades of January the 6th in the United States. We're not the United States, we are Australia, and I think we have to work through this. And as I said, when the Ombudsman says you need an independent overseeing body, I agree with her.
Okay, Matthew, despite all these protests that we saw, the Victorian government is ahead in the polls. I know we don't always listen to polls, but if we do, Labor would win an election if it were held today, and Daniel Andrews still remains popular. The news poll figures appear to be at odds with that anger that we're seeing. Is your party just not connecting the way that it needs to?
Well, I've only been the leader for 2 months,
so
you've got to start somewhere.
No, it's been difficult for your party,
like
I get it, but,
poll,
you know, what are you going to need to do to get some cut through?
Look, the only thing I'd say about opinion polls, and I think we've all seen a lot of them, is that it's not where you start, it's where you finish. And, you know, I remember seeing polls that had Bill Shorten with very large majority, and, you know, I can go back in history as to many others who would have won elections. It's not about opinion polls. It's actually about making sure you're standing for what is right and going to the Parliament with sensible alternatives. And I've spent my time as leader in the second incarnation, 2 months now, putting forward alternatives. And I think that's what people want to hear.
Yeah, well, picking up on what you said, Darren, just this division just seems to be getting bigger. It doesn't seem to be getting smaller. That is definitely something that hopefully can be addressed ASAP. Thank you both very much. Matthew, Darren, good to get
Thanks
you
again.
Ears.
Thank
All
you.
Right.